Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we continue about quadratic equation, and the last video I give you the basic formula or three steps you can apply for solving quadratic equation. With this formula, you can solve any equation you want to. And in this video, we continue learning about quadratic equation with fractional coefficient. The quadratic equation with fractional coefficient we have formed like this: 1 over 2x squared plus 3 over 2x and minus, oh no, this is minus 2. Okay, this is, we have the coefficient of x squared, x, and the constant number is the fractional, like that. And very difficult for solving this equation with the fractional. So the first step I want to apply for this equation is cancel the fractional form. How can I do that? I will multiply both sides of this equation with 2. Why we choose 2 is not another number? Because we see that the denominator of this fraction is 2. So that's why I will multiply by 2. And after multiply, I will got that 1 over 2x squared plus 3 over 2x minus 2 equals 2 multiplied with this bracket like this. And the other side, we also have 2 multiplied 0. And then expand this bracket, we will got that 2 multiplied with 1 over 2. And the number will become to 1, and I got x squared only. 2 multiply 3 over 2x, we got 3x. And 2 multiply with minus 2, you got minus 4. And 0 multiply 2, we got 0. After this step, we only have the integer coefficient, and now very easy for identify a, b, or c. Now we got a is 1, b is 3, and c is minus 4. Compared to the original equation, we got here a equal to 1 over 2, b equal to 3 over 2, and c equal to negative 2. So with this coefficient abc, this value abc is very complicated when applied to find the delta or discriminant and apply to the h1 and h2 formula. But with this equation, with this value, we can see that's very easy for find discriminant. We got discriminant is b squared minus 4ac, and substitute value for b, you got 3 squared minus 4, 1, and multiply c. Because c here, we got negative number, so I will put it into the bracket like this. And the result for discriminant, you got 25. And then we apply for h1. Minus 2 plus square root discriminant divided by 2a, and you got here is negative 3 plus square root 25 and divide by 2 multiply 1, and the result of this calculating is 1. For h2, we got the same formula, but you have to change from the plus here become the minus. Square root of discriminant divided by 2a, and you will have the result of this one is negative 4. Yes. So h1 and h2 will be 1 and negative 4. For this kind of exercise, fractional, after we multiply with some number, you will got the integer number, and after that, you should apply the formula of quadratic equation for solving that. Now, next example. The second example for this question, you can see that the value of a is 1 over 3, b 1 over 2, and c is negative 5 over 6. This is complicated coefficient, so it makes you very difficult for finding h1 and h2. So that's why I need to cancel fractional form in this question. And I went through some number for multiplying here. And which number will you choose? Maybe you can choose 3 or 2 or 6, but in this case especially, I will multiply by 6, because after multiply by 6, I got all coefficient here become to integer. Look at this. I will take a bracket for this one and multiply with 6, and 0 multiply with 6 also. So after multiply, you got 6 multiply 1 over 3, you become to x squared. 6 multiply 1 over 2 become to 3x. And 6 multiply with negative 5 over 6, I got negative 5. And equal to 0, because 0 multiply 6 equal to 0. After this step, very easy for determine a is 2, b is 3, and c is negative 5. And then using the discriminant formula, you got b squared minus 4ac, and 3 squared minus 4, 2, and negative 5. This is, we got 49. Yes, 49. And how about h1? Negative b plus square root of discriminant divided by 2a, and negative 3 plus square root of 49 divided by 2 multiply 2. The question will be 1. And the same thing for h2, you got negative 3, negative square root of 49, and divided by 4, because 2 multiply 2 equals 4. Negative 3, negative 7, you got negative 10. Negative 10 divided by 4, you got negative 5 over 2. So this is solution for this question. H1 is 1 and H2 is negative 5 over 2. Okay, the first step you want to solve the fractional coefficient of quadratic equation is cancel fractional form. That's all. Very easy. Hope you can understand and apply to your test.